be happy the whole day and in our life. It's very, very essential nowadays. During the pandemic period, the people, we are very much stressful in our life, in our day-to-day activity. So the Almighty God will give us to all strength, all kind of strength here. So with this a short prayer to all, here I would like to welcome all the people, those present here. First of all, I welcome all the faculty members from Ahmed Business School, the faculty members from other colleges and universities, because you are all the vibrant participant, so that I take the more privilege to welcome you all here. Then I welcome our executive director, Dr. Deepa Rajesh here, on behalf of the organizing committee. I welcome ma'am for this wonderful occasion of the one-day seminar on the intellectual property rights. It's very, very essential one nowadays here. Then I take privilege to welcome our HOD, Dr. Srinivasan sir, and Dr. Rendamani sir, our Dean of Academic the Ahmed Business School, Dr. N. Srinivasan, and all other members here. And also I take privilege to welcome all the HODs from the various department of Ahmed University. And last but not least here, I take privilege to welcome to all other faculty members from various colleges, universities, and fellow other faculty members here. See, as far as concern about this one day seminar on intellectual property rights, it's very, very essential. The main objective of this seminar is to create awareness, very particularly among the faculty members and the research scholars, about our own property rights. See, everybody, we have our own property rights. We are doing something that, we are inventing something that, we are trying to innovatively produce something and innovatively introduce to the public. But at the same time, we are not supposed to knowing about our own rights to how to claim our own innovations, our own products, our own creations, our own ideas, our own thoughts. Many of us, we don't know. So in that scenario, we have to create awareness on your creations, to create derivative works, and in what way you got to perform in the society. The seminar, definitely it will help you, and it will encourage us to distribute and to share your informations, your own ideas and the data, instead of keeping very confidential. Because why I'm telling all those things here in the introduction part here, see, many of us not knowing about what is the patent right, what is intellectual property rights. We heard about the intellectual property rights. Very frequently we are knowing about, we are hearing about IPR, IPR. But many of us be not knowing about what is IPR. Intellectual property means what? See, the rights, how, in what way we have to claim our own ideas, our own property. That is the important thing. But many of us, they keeping this idea in confidential. But in the open forum, to open up these confidential ideas, to knowing everything, to knowing many aspects. So for that purpose only we are organizing the seminar here, national level seminar. So this seminar definitely will provide a legal defense and offers to the creators of their work, definitely. So with this small introduction about the program, now I would like to invite and welcome our today's guest, Dr. Mr. S. Uday Shankar from National Information Center from Chennai. And also, I'm very happy to welcome you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Uday Shankar, sir.
Thank you, sir.
On behalf of our Amit University, as well as our organizing team and all the faculty members and our executive director and also other participants, on behalf of them, I welcome you, sir. And also, I'm happy to briefly introduce about our guest, yes, Uday Shankar here. He's a ME mechanical engineer. Presently, he is in the assistant controller of patents, IPR, in National Information Center, Government of India, at Chennai. It's functioning here. Mr. Uday Shankar, he has a lot of experience, more than 11 years as an examiner in patent. Not only that, Mr. Uday Shankar, he worked more than 7 years as assistant controller of patents. He has given more than 25 guest lectures, visited too many countries like Japan and other countries here. At present, he is working as an assistant controller of patents in IPR. So with this brief introduction about Dr. Mr. S. Uday Shankar, once again, on behalf of you all, I welcome Mr. S. Uday Shankar. Now I request our guest to over to Mr. Uday Shankar, sir, to present about the introduction of IPR. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, everybody. Thank you very much for inviting me to this wonderful program about intellectual property rights. My sincere thanks to Amit Management, Amit Business School, Dr. Deepa Rajesh, Executive Director, Amit University, Dr. R. Srinivasan, Head of Department, Amit Business School, Dr. C. Manoharan, Professor, Amit Business School, and Organizing Committee, and the participants. Hope everybody are doing well in this pandemic situation, by God's grace. Last year, that is before this pandemic, personally have visited more than 15 colleges and universities for giving this presentation about intellectual property rights in person. But the only problem which I face in giving this webinar is there won't be one-to-one interaction. Wherever I go, especially to the universities, colleges, the professors like you are highly qualified. They're having a lot of information, lot of knowledge. Generally, we share something to them and they share something to us. So there will be a lot of knowledge transfer in that single room, in that auditorium. Lot of knowledge transfer will be there. We learned a lot of things from your side. That is the only thing we are missing when we are giving this webinar. But I hope this will be changed very soon and we will meet in person in the near future. Thank you. I'm not going to teach you everything, just I'm going to share some knowledge which we are having, which you know already, but you don't know where to use that knowledge correctly. That is the main object of this presentation. Wherever you go, you hear the name intellectual property rights. So what is meant by intellectual property rights? The final, the last one, we divide this IPR into three things: intellectual, property, and rights. Rights is your fundamental rights, like right for education, right for speech, right for expression, In the same way, this right also your fundamental rights. In the middle, property is there. What does it mean by property? Your house is your property, your car is your property, your jewels is your property, the land is your property. With the property, I'm sure you are going to get some monetary benefit. Whenever you have some property, automatically it will give some monetary benefit to you. The same way here also, we are meaning the property as it is. Intellectual. Intellectual means your knowledge. From your knowledge, you are going to get some property. That property is your fundamental rights. This is called intellectual property right. This is your fundamental right. Your knowledge is your fundamental rights. With your knowledge, you are going to get some benefits, some monetary benefits. That is your fundamental rights. We are coming under Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Why we are coming under commerce? Commerce means business. Why intellectual property is coming under commerce? Because people going to use the knowledge for getting monetary benefits. Sir, I am audible, sir. Hello.
Yes, sir. Audible, sir.
Sir, if anything, yes, sir. Please, yes, sir. Let me know, sir.
Yes, audible, sir. Okay. Carry on.
Awesome. So we are coming under Ministry of Commerce because commerce means doing in business. Here also you are going to do business, but here you are going to do business with your intellectual knowledge. That's what we are coming under. Intellectual property rights is coming under commerce. Okay. Understanding this intellectual property concept simply by this example. Suppose I purchased a book on the roadside. I am living in Chennai. I purchased a book related to some philosophy on the roadside. No bill and other thing, just bargain, and I purchased that book. When I read the book, I feel it is very interesting. And I want to give to my friend to read. I have given the book to my friend. After 1 week or after some times, when I asked the book back, he said that book is belongs to him. Actually, who is the owner for that book? I am the owner for that book. I have given to him for reading. After some times, he is claiming that he is the owner for that book. So I felt it is an injustice to me. With good faith only I have given the book to him. Now he is not returning back and he is saying that he is the owner for that. So I felt I some injustice has been done to me. Whenever you feel injustice, where you will go? Automatically to the court. So I went to the court. When the court, during the argument, the judge asked me, what is the proof you are having that you are the owner for the book? I don't have any proof, no bill, because I purchased in the roadside. And he also don't have any book, any bill or anything. So both of them don't have any evidence to prove. So we cannot give justice to in this case. Clear? In another scenario, I purchased a new bike. It is a very good bike. I want to give one ride to my friend. I have given. He has taken my bike. When I ask the bike back, he's saying that he is the owner for the bike. Again, injustice. Again, I went to the court. Now the court is asking for the evidence. What evidence I am having and what evidence he having to claim the ownership. I have an evidence known as RC book. In that RC book, my name is there. My bike number is there. My bike color is there. Every detail is given in the RC book in my name. So the court will easily decide that I am the owner for that bike. It is a property. Bike is my property. So easily I am giving my evidence. So who given this evidence to me? A government, not a private body. A state government, we say as RTO, they have given the rights to me in the form of a document so that wherever I go, if anybody claims that the bike belongs to them, and I easily produce the evidence, that is that RC book, and I claim the ownership. Clear? The first case, that is book, I don't have any evidence. The second case, I have bike, I have evidence. If it is a car, I have evidence. If it is a house, I have evidence. So wherever I can produce the evidence, I can easily claim the ownership. Nobody can cheat me. Clear. This is also property. Here also we are talking about intellectual property. But here, before the property, the word intellectual always come from our mind, the idea, the knowledge. When you are expressing an idea, expressing your knowledge to someone, if the someone claim that that idea is belongs to them, what is the proof you have it? For tangible form, tangible means we can touch, we can see. For tangible property, evidence is there. For intangible property, that is your knowledge, what evidence you have? How you prove this is my idea, this is came from my mind? How you prove? There comes a tool called intellectual property rights. Intellectual property rights protect your knowledge by giving a certificate, so that you wherever if somebody used your knowledge, you can easily protect them, you can protect yourself from infringing by others. This is called intellectual property rights. Hope you are clear now. For tangible property, you have evidence. For intangible property, that is your knowledge or intellectual ideas, you need some evidence so that you can protect your knowledge. That evidence is given by intellectual property rights. The first case, that is for bike, the evidence, the authority is given by by the state government. Here, the authority is given to you by same government, but central government. Central government is the only authority can give intellectual property rights. Intellectual property that purely belongs to the central government, not belongs to any state government. Clear? Okay. So, invention. So, whenever you are talking about patents, the intellectual property having various divisions. Out of that, the first division is patents. What is patent? Before going to patents, you should be very clear what is mean by invention. Generally, we say invention means something new. The invention can be done only by a scientist. The invention can be done only by a great people, not by ordinary people. Ordinary people can make use of that invention, but they cannot become an inventor, because invention is always related to a bigger one. Highly qualified, knowledgeable scientist only can do invention. Ordinary people cannot do invention. This is the common opinion most of the people have. Students, even some teachers also having the same opinion, because invention means it should be done by a great people. This opinion is coming because you are giving a definition for invention as something new. Who will find something new when they have extraordinary quality? They can only find something new. Ordinary people cannot find something new. This is a problem in because of the definition you are giving for invention. So we are redefining the definition for invention like this. Invention means a solution to a technical problem. That solution may be a simple solution or complicated solution, whatever may be. There should be a solution to your technical problem. Lot of problem we are having. Social problem, political problem, family problem, lot of problems you are having. But we are talking about technical problem. A solution to the technical problem is called invention. Clear? Just you make note of that definition, so that wherever you go, if you are teaching something to a student, to say invention means not something new. It should be a small solution, simple solution to your existing technical problem. Now you see what is mean by technical problem. This is a hybrid two-wheeler. This vehicle run by both petrol as well as by electrical battery, electric. Most of the two-wheelers in general having a common features. Many common features are there, but generally I'm telling a stand. Two types of stand we are having for two wheelers. One is central stand, another was one of them is side stand. So the side stand is common to all type of two wheelers. Every two wheelers will have this side stand. So what is the problem with the side stand, using the side stand? When you are using the central stand, there won't be any problem. It is very clear. But whenever you are using a side stand which is more convenient, there is a problem. What is the problem? You will forget to take the stand back. Then there is a chance for accident. Clear? The main drawback in using the side stand is most of the time many people will forget to take the stand back. So accident is possible. This is a device. We called in mechanical engineering, we call this, we generally we call this as a bike, but in a mechanical term we call this a device. Some device. When a device having some problem, that is considered as a technical problem. Clear? The stand is belongs to this device. That stand having some problem, that is the rider will forget to take it back. So this is called as technical problem. So now you are clear what is mean by technical problem. So what is the solution for that problem? The simple solution. Simple solution is providing a blinking light nearby that handbar, somewhere visible. Providing a blinking light nearby the handbar so that the rider can see. Whenever you start the ignition, suppose you are not taking back the side stand, the light will automatically blink so that you can find out. Clear? A simple solution. So there is a problem, there is a solution. This solution is called considered as an invention. So who is giving that solution? Someone. That someone is called as inventor. Clear? So this is the way we are considering invention, and this is the way we are recognizing the inventor. The patent office always see a simple solution, whoever may be giving the solution, he is considered as an inventor, not as an ordinary man. He's become an inventor because he has given the solution. So there is a problem, there is a solution. Now I am asking you whether the problem is completely solved, the side stand problem, by providing a blinking light. I will say no, because most of the time the rider, the busy rider, will not notice the blinking light. Who will see the blinking light? You will start the ignition, switch on the vehicle, and you will go without noticing the blinking light. The stand is already out, so you will fall down. So what will be the next solution? What will be the further development or further solution? Further solution will be by providing a buzzer. It will make a noise. Even though you are not seeing the blinking light, you can hear the noise. So another solution I am giving. Already one solution is given. Now I am giving another solution. That is providing a buzzer. Whenever you are not taking the stand, if you are switching on the ignition, it will make noise. Beep sound it will make. So that you can have the idea that you will take the stand back. So again, another problem, another solution. Second person give the solution. So second invention, though who is given the invention, the second person is considered as another inventor. Already first inventor is there. Now the second inventor, he is also inventor. Now the problem is solved or not? Still I say no, because somebody will not never notice the blinking light. Even they will not listen the sound also, because a busy city like Chennai, there is no possibility of listening the beep sound, because outside noise is more, and suppose you are wearing a headphone hearing some song, and the chances for not listening, not noticing the light as well as the sound. So what will be the next solution? The next solution is whenever you switch on the ignition, if the stand is not taken back, the engine will not start. Engine will not start means what is the problem of falling down? You cannot ride the bike. The ultimate solution is the engine will not start. So the problem will be completely solved. For the same problem, I have given three solutions. Three solution means three invention. Three person, three inventor. There is no superior invention or inferior invention. All are considered as invention. The patent office will consider everything as an invention, and every idea will be protected by intellectual property rights. Clear? This is the way invention are carried out throughout the world. Nobody will invent something extraordinary new, because all extraordinary new things are already invented by many people. Now invention are done by mere modification of existing one. Already the light is there, so they got patent that is running. They have the rights to sell it in the market without any problem of infringement. So somebody will think about, why can't we provide a buzzer sound so that the protection will be more. They have invented something. They have their own arrangement, and they came out with a invention. They got also patent that is also running in the market. And the third one, the injection will not start. That is also an invention. They are also in the market. They also got the patent rights. So these three people can enjoy the monopoly rights as an inventor. But the problem is same. If the fourth person comes, he come out with another problem, then also we are considering that as an invention, and the fourth person will consider as a fourth inventor. See, for a single problem, how many solution we are giving? Any number of solution you can give for any type of technical problem. This is one of the technical problem I am telling. If you find some problem in the bar, in the handbar, or in the tire, in the braking system, in the engine, whatever problem, if you find out, if you are giving some solution, that solution is considered as an invention and even become an inventor. And that invention can be protected by patents, so that third person cannot make use of your knowledge. Clear? This is the way patent office will see the invention, and this is the way we are processing the application. You see the next one. What is this? This is a paper clip. Before someone invented this paper clip, we are using a normal pin. Gundusin solvalinga, normal pin. What is the purpose of that pin? To keep the paper together. Okay, so that is a purpose. So we are using a pin. What is the problem in that using the pin? It will damage the paper. You have to make a hole. It will damage the paper. Clear? Then stapler pin. Stapler pin also damaging the paper. I don't want to damage my paper, but at the same time, I want to keep some of the paper together. So what is the solution? This is a temporary only. If you want to keep the paper together, you have to go for binding another thing. That is a permanent. For temporarily, for office purpose, I want to keep some paper together. So I am inventing this one. So now, what is the problem? What is the existing technology? That is pin. What is the pin? Purpose is same, to keep the paper together. And what is the problem you are identifying? It will damage the paper. So what solution you are giving? I am inventing this one. This will not damage the paper. At the same time, it will keep the paper together. So problem, solution. Purpose is same, to keep the paper together. And this is considered as an invention. But it got patent long back. Now it became open to everybody because the term is already over. But at the time, this became a very good solution for that, keeping the paper together without damaging. And this has considered as an invention, and this got patent protection also. Let's see the next one. This is the same type of paper clip, but in the outer, we have in some plastic coating with the different colors. Why we are going for plastic coating? Inside a steel will be there. When there is a chances of interacting with the water, there is a problem of rusting. With this type of coating, there won't be any rusting. This is a simple solution. This is also considered as an invention. Clear? You see the top one, a syringe with a needle. The previous time, most of the hospital, we are using this type of syringe and needle arrangement. With this, for every patient, they use the same syringe. Just by putting in the hot water, they will use again and again for every patient. After that, they found that some of the bacteria and virus will not die by using mere hot water. So the transfer of disease from one person to another is possible by using the previous one. And also it is very weight. Manufacturing cost is more because steel is there, involvement of steel and other thing. Many problems are there in using the old type of syringe and needle arrangement. So what will be the solution? What is a simple solution? A disposable syringe. The first syringe came not in the manner of disposable one. It's a manner of reusable one, the previous one. One doctor will have one syringe. For many years, he will use the same one again and again. When they found some problem coming with this type of one, they went for disposable type of syringe. Use and throw. One time you will use and will throw it out. So this is the advantage of using disposable syringe. They did not transfer disease from one person to another. It is highly hygienic. So you can throw like this. Dispose like this. Clear. Now, what is patent? Patent is an exclusive right granted by a state for a period of 20 years. You will get patent rights only for the period of 20 years. After 20 years, it will go to the public. Anybody can copy your invention. You cannot do anything, but 20 years, you can enjoy the monopoly rights. To prevent third parties from act of making, using, offering for sale, or importing the product or process in which the invention is incorporated. Without your consent, nobody can make, use, sell, import, export. Nothing can be done without your consent. Once you got the patent for your invention, without your consent, nobody can do anything for the period of 20 years. Because you have that patent certificate, wherever go, if you feel that somebody is infringing or copying your invention, directly you can go to the court. Easily the court will decide, and the huge compensation you can get from the infringer. Okay, so this is a fundamental definition for patents. Okay, how the patent system is working? There is a balance. One side it is a patentee interest, and another side it is a public interest. So what is mean by patentee interest? Suppose you are an inventor, you are inventing a medicine. That medicine will cure some deadly disease like cancer, for example, I'm telling you. By taking the medicine, a cancer patient can come out from the disease completely. This is the significance of your medicine. You have spent a lot of money, lot of effort, lot of labor, lot of time to invent that medicine. Now you are giving to the public. Now you are selling in the market. Immediately what will happen? The competitor company or the person who involved in the same type of research will easily copy your invention. Easily copy your invention, and they will manufacture the same medicine very easily without any knowledge. But what is the, who is the loser? You are the loser, because the knowledge is yours, the labor is yours, money is yours, time is yours, everything you did, everything belongs to you. But once you disclose the medicine in the market, the competitor will easily copy without any effort, easily will copy, and they will become a very big competitor for you. They will start selling in the market. If you are an individual person doing this research and disclosing to the public, and this is copied by a big company, can you fight with the company? They're having a lot of infrastructure, a lot of money. You are an individual person. Can you fight with the company? No. So what will happen? The huge loss on your side. You will become depressed. You can't do anything. If you go to the court, if you go to the police station, wherever you go, nobody will accept that you are the inventor. Like I purchased the book on the roadside. No evidence. The same way you have no evidence. But the patent system giving protection to the inventor by way of giving the certificate. The way of giving the certificate, they are protecting the interest of the patentee. Now you can, after getting the certificate, now you can easily disclose your invention to the public. If anybody copy, even a very big company copied your invention, you are an individual, a normal person, but you have the patent rights, patent certificate. Now you are disclosing. Now the huge company is, a very big company is copying that. If you go to the court, nothing can be happened. The court will easily decide that you are the owner. The huge amount of compensation the company has to give to you. The company cannot do anything because you're having the valid patent certificate. Without the certificate, if you go to the public, anybody can copy. Anybody can copy your invention. It's not only for medicine. for any type of invention, whether it is in chemistry field, mechanical field, electrical, even in a business, whatever thing you are disclosing without protection, anybody can copy and you cannot do anything. This is the one side. The next side, public interest. How the public is benefited. You have invented a medicine which is going to cure a deadly disease. Suppose you are not disclosing to public. You are keeping with yourself. So what is the use of public? Ultimately, who is going to use that medicine? Public. But you are not giving out. If somebody asks you why you are not giving, you are saying that when I give out, somebody will copy. So I will not give. But with the patent system, you can give without any fear. So when you are giving out, the public will be benefited. So the patent system is seeing the interest of the patentee by giving the protection. At the same time, by protecting the patentee is without fear disclosing his invention to the public. So the public will be benefited by using the medicine. Not only using the medicine, when the public is seeing your research paper, they can do further research. The public means anybody. He may be an inventor, he may be a scientist, he may be a research scholar, he may be a professor. Public is include everything. So somebody who is interested in your research, they can do further research. That further research can be possible, but they cannot copy your invention as it is. For example, I'm telling you, your invention is A plus B equal to C. That is your invention. When adding A component with B, you are getting C component. That C component is used to cure some deadly disease. That is your invention you are disclosing, you are giving to the government. The government, after receiving the entire document, they are examining that one and they are giving a certificate to you. After getting the certificate, you are disclosing that invention or research to the public. The public, whoever interested, will do further research with A plus B equal to C, further research. If someone come with another solution, for example, with A already is there, with B already is there, he adding another component. For example, it is X. By adding X component, if the efficiency of the C getting increases, in your research, the efficiency of the C is 80%, for example, I'm telling you. When adding the X, somebody is adding, doing the further research, they're adding an X component so that the efficiency is increased to 85%. So that can be invented. He cannot get patent or he cannot copy exactly A plus B equal to C. But by doing further research, he adding another component, that is X. With that another component, the efficiency will increase by more, 5% more means. That become another invention. You clear? He is not copying. He is doing further research. But further research is increasing the efficiency by some other means. That some other means is considered as another solution, another invention. And he can get protection for that extra research. Clear? So in this way, research will carry on again and again by many people. Somebody interested, he can do further research on his paper, his research. In the way, research will be a continuous process. So patent system balance the interest of the patentee by giving protection. At the same time, it will be benefited by the public by using the medicine as well as by doing further research. This is the way the patent system is working. So how does patent system, what does patent system do? It encourages research. As I told, when you are disclosing, further research is possible by some other person. So it encourages the research. Induce an inventor to disclose his invention. Correct. It will induce you to disclose. Otherwise, what will happen? Nobody will disclose. If I disclose, somebody will copy. I cannot do anything. In this situation, nobody will disclose. But here, the patent system says, give your invention to us. We give the certificate so that you can disclose without fear. Nobody can copy. If anybody copy, you go to the court will give much compensation to you. So nobody will copy. Yeah. So induce an inventor to disclose his invention. Capital investment, technological development will be there. It encourages establishment of new industry. When there is a new research, new industry is possible. When there is no research, no new industries will come. So everything will be stagnant. It becomes stagnant. So patent system always encourage to do research, encourage to open new industries for capital investment, and encourage technological development, everything, and it also induce the inventor to disclose the invention to the public. Otherwise, nobody will disclose their invention. Clear? This is the way patent system is working. So if you have any doubt, hello, Manoharan sir. Hello. Hello.
Towards the end, they will ask you questions, sir.
End, you will ask, no, madam.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. It is audible, madam. It is audible and correct.
Yes, sir. You are.
Yes, sir. Audible, sir.
Okay. Shall I continue?
Yes, sir. Continue, sir.
Okay, sir. So this is the part one. This is a patent system. The patent is always related to an invention. So whenever you are doing some invention, you have to go for patents. Okay. Just remember again and again, patent. The whenever you hear the word patent, the next word should be an invention. Again, the next word should be a, what is mean by invention? A simple solution for a technical problem. Solution may be very, very simple. If the solution is solving some technical problem, that is considered an invention, and that invention can be protected by patent system. Clear? So now we are going to next division. Next division is design, industrial design. Patent is entirely different from design. So what is mean by design? Design is nothing but any design of an article so that the article can give some, article can attract the customer. Only aesthetic appearance. The appearance is known as design. Three type of pictures are there. One is car arrangement, another one is chair, another one is a juicer. I don't know what is the name for this one. I call this as a juicer. In the juicer, the top portion is there. Some slots are there. From there, you can squeeze the fruit. So the juice will be collected under the jar. And with the help of the handle, you can pour the juice out. That is one small opening is there. And cap is there. All the arrangement you can see, I think. So handle, very, very important to take the juicer, and the top portion to squeeze the fruit, and one opening, small projection opening to pour the juice out. Everything is important. Clear? So what is the necessity for some blue colors? Can you see the blue color design all over the jar? Blue color design. What is the necessity for blue color? Any technical problem is there? Any solution is there? Some diagram is there. Two person are running. One building is there. Some flowers like structures are there. Can you see that? Can you find out any advantage in that? Suppose I am removing the blue color. What will happen? That design. What will happen? That jar will not work or work. It will work or not? It will work. Because the blue color is only to attract the customer, only for attraction. If you remove the blue color and you replace with red color, then also the jar will work. If you remove everything and you produce in the white color, then also jar will work. The main thing should be the top portion, that is the juicer portion, and the handle and the opening. That is three things are very, very important. But there is no important for these colors. But still we are giving color, you can have different color, different design, only to attract the customer. Aesthetic appearance, that is called as industrial design. You see the car, seat is there, over the seat, different colors they are given. Why can't only blue color, why can't white color, plain color? Why you are going for different colors? See how many colors are there. If you see any car, inside the car, so many colors are there. Just to give attraction. Some people will attracted by this color. Some other customer will go for some other color. So based on the taste of the customer, different colors they're having. Only to attract the customer. It's called industrial design. There is no technology involvement. Only your idea. Here the intellectual idea you are producing to attract the customer, that is coming under industrial design. when you are giving some beautiful idea, beautiful design that will attract the customer, immediately somebody will copy that one. Clear? If you are giving some attractive colors or attractive patterns to the ornaments, to the article, when you are selling in the market, immediately the opponent will copy that one. So this is also your knowledge. This is also coming from your mind, intellectual mind. So this is also considered as intellectual property, and it will be protected by industrial design, not by patents, because patent is only for invention, technical solution. Here there is no technical solution. Here there is no problem. Here only for attraction, attracting the customer. That is called industrial design. See, what is the condition for that? Yeah, industrial design is that aspect of useful article which is ornamental or aesthetic, just for attraction. It may be two-dimensional features like patterns, lines, color, etc., and three-dimensional features like shape, surface of the article. You can have a two-dimensional attraction like giving some good colors, good lines, and etc., but to attract the customer, or you can go for three-dimensional by changing the shape, by changing the surface of the article, anything you can done to attract the customer. For example, shape of a handle or body portion of a pressure cooker. Shape of the handle, whatever the shape may be, just for attraction. If the handle is in a this particular shape, the efficiency will get increases, means no. The shape of the handle not going to do anything with the cooker, just for attraction. And the shape of the cooker is not also not going to play any role. If it is a oval shape, it is a square shape, whatever my shape may be, the inside rice will cook on their own, the pressure only, not by the shape of the cooker. The shape of the cooker not going to solve any technical problem. It is only for attraction. So that is coming under industrial design. A design must be, the condition is the design must be new or original and industrially reproducible. It should be new. You cannot copy any color or lines or any shape from already existing one. If Prestige Cooker is producing a cooker in a particular color or particular shape, the Hawkins Cooker Company cannot copy the same one. They can go for some other shape, some other color to attract the customer, but they cannot copy the existing one already. Pressure that Preeti, for example, Preeti having a black color coating on the outside surface of the cooker to attract the customer. If the Hawkins manufacturing cooker with the same black color, it will be violating the industrial design. So you should not copy that one. You should go for some other color or some other means to attract the customer, provided the Prestige Cooker Company should register for an industrial design. They have to register, they have to get the certificate. The same way, when they are doing some invention, they are getting protection by patents. The same way, when they are going for a new design, they have to get protection through design protection by getting a certificate from the intellectual property office. Clear? Patent is related to invention, design is related to a pure design for attracting the customer. Clear? See another design of the jar. The design of the jar, the handle is square shape, just for attraction, no technical advancement, just for attraction. Instead of that square shape or rectangle shape, if I am providing a circular shape, that is also good. But whatever shape you are giving, it is for attraction only. It's not going to do anything inside the thing. If suppose it is this jar is used for heating water, technology is very, very important. How you are heating the water. The handle not going to do anything with the heating process. Heating process will completely done by some technology, not by the shape of the handle. But still, we are concentrating more on the shape of the handle to attract the customer. When you are going for to attract the customer by means of design, that knowledge, that intellectual knowledge can be protected by design protection, not by patents. Patent is entirely different. Now you are talking about second option, that is for design protection, only for attracting the customer. So these are all some of the consumer product. The different colors, different shape, different attraction. See the iron box, for example, iron box. See the shape, see the color. The main purpose of the iron box, the main component for the iron box is the bottom. The bottom should be flat. The bottom should conduct the heat transfer properly. Clear? That is the main purpose of iron box. What is the use of providing a blue color on the top, blue color on the bottom, white with blue combination? See the shape of the handle, shape of the iron box overall, just to attract the customer, just to attraction. You see the top one, toothbrush. The tip is yellow color and blue and white combination, and white and dark blue combination. Nothing can. What if suppose I'm purchasing a red color brush instead of blue color, red color, what will happen? Nothing will happen. The ultimate purpose of using brush to clean our teeth. Clear? So the bristle provided in the brush is very important. What material they are providing, that is very, very important. Material is very, very important. Color is not important. Color does not going to play any role in cleaning our teeth. The material, the bristle material is going to play an important role, but still they are going to give some color. Why? To attract the customer. Instead of plain brush, you see the how attractive it was, so that you can easily buy that one. The same way, brush, bag, scissor. See the scissor, red and red color. The handle they are giving. See the shape of the handle. One is round, another one is oval shape. Maybe they can say it is convenient to cut the paper, but still, why the color? I'm asking. The color is only for attraction. See another type of iron box I am providing. See the difference between the first one and second one. The bottom is obviously same, and see the shape of the iron box, and see the color. Everything is different. Why? To attract the customer. Even the same company can produce many different of iron box with many different colors, or the competitor go for another color and shapes. The bottom is maybe same. So how to attract the customer? When the bottom is same, when the ultimate purpose is same, how to attract the customer? Only by providing your attraction, beautiful design. So design will play a very, very important role in manufacturing your product. A separate group will be there in every company, manufacturing company. A separate group of team of people will be there. They will do only design work. They will do only adding more and more features. It is not at all related to technology. Technology related team is entirely different. The R&D department, they do technical aspect. They will go for patents. To attract the customer, another group will be there in the same company. They will only concentrate on design. They will attract the people. They put many combination of color combination, line combination, shape combination, so that a new product will come out. So attraction is very, very important. This attraction is done by a design protection. See the pharmaceutical product. These are all pharmaceutical products. See the designs, see the colors. The tablet is red and yellow color. Inside the medicine, what medicine is inside? That is important. Color is not important, but still they are giving some color. Soap dispensing device, syringe and needle arrangement, shape of the needle, just for attraction. Just for attraction, no other technology involved, just for attracting the customer. Textile and jewelries. Most of the designs will be carried out in this field, textile and jewelries. No technology, only design to attract the customer. These are all some of the examples involved. Our intellectual knowledge, everything will be protected. Everything should be protected. Otherwise, the competitor will easily copy your invention, copy your knowledge. A third one is trademark. trademark always related to doing business. Whenever you are doing, you are planning to do business, the first thing you have to do, you have to select a name for your company or for your product, and that should be registered under trademark. Otherwise, the competitor will easily copy your trademark. Okay. To see some of the examples, first one is tick. Whenever I'm seeing that you are seeing the tick, immediately you will say it is belongs to Adidas, Apple, computer related thing, GM, General Motors, and Hilton. Hilton means group of hotels. And the star symbol, car, Benz. Lacoste belongs to garments. And that ball related to Pepsi. Nowhere the company name has been written. Just tick. One tick mark, immediately you are thinking about Adidas. And off Apple, immediately you are thinking about computer. GM is General Motors, Hilton. Nowhere it is written, it is related to hotel. But still you will think about it is a hotel. Lacoste, a crocodile symbol is there. The name is Lacoste. Generally you think about garments. Crocodile means crocodile company, Lacoste means Lacoste company. It is related to a garment. By seeing the symbol, the people can recognize the product. That is the advantage of trademark. So not by definition, just by seeing the symbol, they can recognize the company or the product, and also the reputation of the company, quality of the product. That is the advantage of having a trademark. Whenever you are going to do some business, when you are going to produce some product, the first step you have to do, you have to register for a trademark. Then only you can produce the product and sell it in the market without any fear. Okay. So trademark, what is trademark? A trademark is any sign which can distinguish the goods of one trader from those of another. Sign includes words, logos, pictures, or a combination of these. A trademark is nothing but it will distinguish the goods from one traders from another. See, suppose you want to buy a sari. What is the first thing you will decide? Which shop you have to go? Pothys is there, Chennai Silk is there. So which shop you will select? Pothys or Chennai Silk? Suppose you are selecting Pothys. Why you are selecting Pothys? Because you have some idea that Pothys will have some good quality of sari. By the name Pothys, you are getting an idea that the shop belongs to a garments, saris, and other dress materials, and also the quality of the product is good. Just by telling the name, this is the advantage of having a trademark. If I say Sony, immediately you will think about some electrical goods, camera, TV, or whatever may be, and next impression you will get Sony means good quality. The quality of the product will be good, reliable. So these type of information you are getting by just telling the name or just seeing the symbol. That is the advantage of trademark. It will distinguish the product from one trader to another. Many traders are there. Many traders are manufacturing TV. But which one you are selecting? How you are selecting? You are selecting by trade name, trademarks. By selling the trademarks only, you are selecting the product. That is the advantage of trademark. A trademark is used as a marketing tool so that customer can recognize the product of a particular trader. By the particular trader, you have some impression. Most of the people will have some impression on a particular product. They want to buy that product. For that, you need some name. You need some symbol. That will be given by a trademark. To register a trademark, the master, this is a condition. Now you understood what understand what is the use of trademark. Okay. Now what is the condition for getting the trademark? Two conditions they are telling. It should be distinctive and it should not be deceptive. First condition, it should be distinctive from the existing one. Many type of trademarks are already existing in the market. So now you are going to get a new trademark name. It should be distinctive from the existing one. Okay. Then it also, it should not be deceptive. Deceptive means it should not misguide. We'll see what is meant by deceptive later. Or contrary to a law. It should not be contrary to a law or morality. And not identical to similar on earlier marks for the same or similar. It should not be identical to your already existing one. Because already existing one is Sony. The same Sony you should not keep for your product. Because Sony is already a registered trademark. It is in the market. When you are producing a new product, you should not keep a name as Sony. When you are opening a new company, you should not keep your company name as Sony, because Sony is already there, already registered trademark. So you have to go for some other one. That means it should not be similar to the existing goods or services. Clear? So some conditioning should be distinctive. It should not be deceptive. It should not be contrary to the law or morality, and should not be identical to the existing product. This is the condition for trademarks. See, here are three type of things I'm showing. First one is Colgate, Pepsodent, Closer. When I say Colgate, what impression will get? What product you will remember? Obviously, paste. When I say Pepsodent, obviously you remember. Your mind will think about paste. Close-up means placed. But three different names. You just see there is any clue which is related to the product. Colgate paste. No. Pepsodent paste. Close-up paste. Any clue they are giving? You just see any clue they are giving. They have given nothing. They have given only Colgate. Immediately you are thinking it is belongs to a paste for cleaning the teeth. There is no clue. Colgate toothpaste for cleaning the teeth. It is in white color. It contains so and so chemical. Nothing details you need. I need only the name. When I say, and somebody say the name, it is Colgate. Immediately I recognize this belongs to a toothpaste or a brush. That is the advantage of Colgate. Now you will decide whether to buy Colgate or whether to buy Pepsodent or Closer. The customer will decide by means of advertisement and other thing, or by means of experience, long time experience in using all the paste. They come to the conclusion that Colgate is best, Pepsodent is best, or Closer is best. They will decide. But the company, before starting the product, they will select a name and they will register. You see the registered R mark in the Colgate, R round. That means it's a registered trademark. Nobody can use the name Colgate for their own product, because already it is registered, already available in the market. This is the advantage of getting trademarks. So what some of the condition I am telling? A trademark can be a word such as Ford or Toyota. It may be a word. You can select a word, Ford or Toyota. If I say Toyota, immediately you will recognize it is a car company. Ford car company. Okay. It can be abbreviation such as IBM. It may be an abbreviation. You can keep an abbreviation also for getting a trademark. It can be made out of device or figurative elements, that is logos. You can select a logos also to keep as a trademark logo. It can be a number, it can be a letter, it can be a slogan, and in some countries smell also using as a trademark. But in India, we are not giving smell as a trademark. We are giving for logos, for letter, for abbreviation, for any type of name. We are giving trademark. A logo can be a two-dimensional or three-dimensional device. Logo can be anything, two-dimensional or three-dimensional. Color feature of trademark can also be protected. Suppose you are giving a unique color to your product, unique color to your company. That is also protected under trademarks. Holograms also protected under trademarks. So what is the two character of trademark? It must be distinctive. That means it should have some difference. It should something different from the already existing product, existing trademark. Then only the customer will recognize. Colgate already is there. Suppose you are manufacturing, you are starting a company which is going to produce a toothpaste. Now you want to give your want to get a trademark, what name you get? Already Colgate, suppose you the same Colgate you can keep, then the public will get confused which one is a real Colgate company, which is one the next company, competitor company. So you have to go for some trademark which should be distinctive from the already existing one, okay? And it should not be deceptive. Deceptive means it should not misguide the public. It should not misguide the public. So distinctive, how to select a trademark? Lion is a distinctive trademark for date syrup. Lion date syrup, okay? What is the relation between lion and date syrup? The advertisement, they show if you take lion date syrup, you will become like a lion. They are showing the advertisement like that. If you take lion dates, you will become, or you get a strength like a lion. But the truth is, lion will not take dates. Lion will not eat in the forest. Lion will not eat date syrup. It will eat some other animal only. But they are comparing date syrup with the strength of the lion. So that lion date syrup means it's entirely different. There is no relation between lion and the date syrup. But still they are having a trademark, choosing a trademark as a lion. So it is distinctive. Previously there is no lion, no trademark. This lion belongs to date syrup. There is no trademark. So it is distinctive. So they are getting trademark. Annapurna is a distinctive trademark for wheat powder. Annapurna may be a name of somebody name. So what Annapurna going to do with wheat powder? No relation, but still they having trademark as Annapurna. Annapurna means immediately you think about wheat powder. Correct. Cycle for Agarbatti. Agarbatti cycle, no relation, but still they having some trademark. Apple for computer. No relation between apple and computer. Whenever you see the apple with half small portion cut, immediately you think about computer. But actually, what is the relation between apple and computer? No relation. This is the character of trademark. There should not be any relation. It should be a unique one. It should be anything. It should be a color. It should be a line. It should be a mark, logo, number, or a coined word. Whatever may see for cycle for Agarbatti. What is the relation? No relation. But still, somebody selected cycle for that Agarbatti. But whenever we see cycle Agarbatti, immediately you will recognize the smell of the Agarbatti, quality of the Agarbatti. Oh, it is good. Already we purchased. It is good. You will recommend to some other buyer. And somebody will thought of buying a wheat powder. Immediately say, you buy Annapurna wheat powder. Achi masala, Shakti masala. Achi Shakti means it's a power, maybe a name, something else. But what is the relation between the masala and Shakti? No relation, but still they are using this. Whenever I say Shakti masala, immediately you will think about various type of masala produced by the Shakti company. Achi masala. These two people are competitor, but they are manufacturing same rasapodi, sambar podi, everything they are manufacturing, but the name is different. This is Achi masala and this is Shakti masala. Masala name only same, but see the trademark Achi and Shakti. Many things like that. Many things. You will get many trademarks like this, but still you are manufacturing same rasapodi only. But the customer will decide which rasapodi to buy by the trademark, Shakti masala or Achi. Clear? This is the distinctive, this is the character of the trademark. Deceptive. Deceptive means you should not misguide the public. You should not tell any, you should not misguide by the name of the trademark. For example, True Basmati. You are a manufacturer of basmati. You are selling in a market. You want to get some some trademark. Why you want to give this name? Why you want to give this name? True basmati. True basmati, like real cotton. Cotton, many people are doing business with cotton, but they have to select some unique trademark for doing the business. You cannot select as real cotton. Real means it is original cotton. Then it means others are not having original cotton. So it is misguide the public, misguide the consumer. So real cotton, best camera, etc. will not be the trademark. They will not allow, the trademark office will not allow this type of trademark. They will not give. They will reject the application. So if you want to get a good trademark, to keep it in your mind, it should be some distinctive. Whatever thing, suppose you are selecting a name, your name, you change the spelling, change the letters, change the font size, change the color, anything you can do. So Kumar shirts, Kumar shirts are there, already Kumar shirts are there. Suppose you also want to do Kumar shirts, but you cannot apply for a trademark because Kumar shirts is already a trademark one. You cannot get Kumar shirt. So for that, you change the spelling for that, you change the color, font size, you add some number, you add some logo, so that the trademark office will give a new trademark certificate to you. It will not mislead the, it will not become a competitor or confusion with the already existing Kumar shirts. This is the best method to just you coin your own trademark for getting that one. Sometimes companies try to achieve distinctive trademark by using invented words. That's what I'm saying. Invented word. Kodak, Nikon, no meaning for that. But when I say Kodak camera, Nikon camera, but these are all invented words. We say as coined word. You can coin it on your own for getting the trademark. So some of the trademark disputes are some of the confusing words. Vaseline, you know Vaseline. Some other company, Vaseline is already trademarked. Then somebody manufactured the same Vaseline powder cream with the name Vanildin. Amrudajan. You see the Amrudajan. It's a bomb. Another company, Amrut Manthan. But when I ask Amrudajan in the company, suppose that fellow is giving Amrut Manthan, can you recognize? How many of we read the name of the company when you are buying something? Product. Just see the color. AM. AM is enough. Amrudajan. We will decide. I just remember because we are asking for Amrudajan. We think that he will give Amrudajan. And we see it is AM. It is enough. But it will be a Amrut Manthan, a duplicate company. This is a way a duplicate company will misguide you. Godrej, Gold Age. Double Bubble. Restorm, Restorm. Fevicol, Trivicol. If you ask Fevicol, if they give Trivicol, you will presume that it is same. You never, most of them never see the difference. But the Trivicol is a duplicate company, not Fevicol, original Fevicol. This is the way competition will happen. This is the way people will cheat the consumer by way of duplicate. In order to avoid these things, any company, any product, they have to get trademark. Otherwise, going to the market is waste. If you are doing very small business, like a vegetable shop, you don't want to go for a bigger company, you don't want to go for big investment, then trademark will not play a very big role in your life in that company. Suppose you are developing, you want to give some more investment, then trademark is must for doing business. Otherwise, anybody will copy, and the later stage, there won't be any proof for you to come out successfully that you are the owner for the company. So trademark is very, very important for doing any type of business. The next one is copyright. Most of the time, people will confuse with patent and copyright. Whatever invention, whatever new technology they are talking, they will say copyright vaangitingla, copyright vaangitingla dhaan kepaanga. Many people who come to patent office will say, sir, when I will get the copyright. So copyright is the familiar word in the intellectual property rights. Patents are very, very non-familiar because patents is always related to your technology. But most of the people who are involved in business, who are involved in teaching, they think copyright and patents are same. No. Patents is only for invention, technical invention. Trademark is doing business, design for getting design protection. Then what is copyright? Copyright is only for literary and artistic work. Only for literature and artistic work. What is literature? Writing books coming under literature. Artistic work, singing. See the singer singing. Photography. Windows 98. Books. Cinematography. Everything is coming under copyright. There is no technology involved here. There is no problem and you are not giving any solution. Problem solution approach only in technology that belongs to patents. Here you are not going to solve any problem. The singer is not going to solve any problem by singing. The photographer not going to solve anybody by taking photograph of this building and other things. Painting not going to solve anything. These are expression of human mind, expression of knowledge. You are expressing something to the society. When you are expressing, somebody will copy. If you are writing a book, you are publishing, and I am copying that. I am putting my own print and I am selling that. Who will be the loser? The author will be the loser. Suppose I am taking a beautiful photograph. Somebody stealing that and selling in the market. And what is the proof that I am the owner for the photograph? There comes copyright protection. Copyright protection is a unique one comparing to other things, because most of the expressions, human expressions, are coming under copyright only. Every people have some expression. Every people, without knowing anything, they are expressing many ideas, many knowledge to the public continuously, and somewhere somebody is copying your knowledge without your permission. That is the problem. A copyright is a protection offered to the works created by the author of literary, dramatic, artistic, musical works, producers of cinematographic films and sound recording. These are all only expressions. You just please understand the difference. These are all only expression. Literature, expression, dramatic, artistic work, musical work, everything is coming from the mind, coming from the knowledge, but they are only expression. They are not going to solve any technology, technical problem. So these are separate thing which is protected under copyright, not by other means, like especially by patents. Patent is purely for inventions, technology. Okay. What are all the ideas? Copyright. See, ideas, fact, titles, and slogan cannot be copyrighted. So what is the difference between first para and last para? A copyright is a protection offered to the works related to literary, dramatic, artistic, musical work. And the last thing I'm telling, ideas, fact, titles, and slogan cannot be copyrighted. What is the difference? Ideas means I'm having many ideas. I am expressing that ideas. That cannot be copyrighted. That expression should be in some tangible form. I am expressing one idea, or expressing one beautiful imagination of one diagram. That cannot be protected. I have to draw that diagram. I have to paint that diagram. I am having one music notes in my mind. I am telling orally. That cannot be protected. I have to produce it in a musical sheet. That should be played by some musical instrument. Then only it is coming under copyright protection. Mere ideas, mere knowledge cannot be protected, because this is not in the tangible form. All intellectual property rights should be in the tangible form. Clear? Should be the tangible form. Then only you can go for a protection. Just coming to the copyright office, just you are telling some idea, they cannot give you a copyright certificate. But idea should be in a tangible form. It should be in a musical note or a diagram or a photography or cinematography. Then only you can get the copyright. Fact means sunrise in the east, rise in the west. That is a fact. You cannot say sunrise in the east, I have find that, you give me copyright. No, that is a fact, known fact cannot be copyrighted. Some slogan, some titles cannot be get copyrighted. See, so far we have discussed about patents, designs, trademark and copyright. In a single product, how these intellectual properties are coming into picture? You see the pressure cooker, premium pressure cooker. Lot of technology involved in this pressure cooker, that is constructional features. See, what are the constructional features? The material, the vessel, and the material of the vessel, handle, and the material of the handle, inside diameter, outside diameter, the closing technology, how the lid and body getting closed, everything is coming under constructional features. Clear? All are belongs to term technology. These technology are protected by patent rights. Yeah, patent rights. Next, design. See the design of the cooker. It is in a black color. The shape of the handle. It is also highlighted in there. See the color of the things. Green color is given. The shape of the handle, shape of the cooker, color of the cooker. Everything is to attract the customer. I already told you, just for attraction. This black color not going to play any role. They will say that this will, that will, that will. No, no technology. Only for attraction. That is coming by design. And trademark. Say the name Premier is there. Premier is written. Whenever I say Premier, immediately you think about pressure cooker. Immediately you think about the quality of the pressure cooker, the life of the pressure cooker. Everything will come in the mind. By the name itself, you decide Premier, Vanda, Wester. We'll go for Hawkins. We go for Prestige. By the name itself, you are selecting the product. That is the significance of trademark. So Premier is coming under trademark. And the catalog booklets or catalog kuduthirupanga pressure cooker la how to use it. So many informations will be there in the catalog. That informations are unique. If the author find this catalog is unique and should be protected, that should be protected by copyrights. So single product, so four types of protection you are having. Conception features patents, designs is design protection, name and logo is coming under trademark, literary and artistic work, for example, booklet or catalog coming under patents. So single product, four different types of, these are all coming under intellectual property rights. We belongs to different categories. Patent office is different, design office is different, trademark office is different, copyright office is different. But we are all coming under intellectual umbrella of intellectual property rights. Clear? So the final one is geographical indication. What is geographical indication? Some of the product will grow in a particular place. For example, Nagpur orange. The orange you can get many places, but particularly the orange grow in a Nagpur having a unique taste. Laddu, Tirupati laddu. In many places you are getting laddu, but Tirupati laddu is a special one. Why special means it is only made by the people belongs to that place. Then only it will be get geographical indication protection. This geographical indication cannot be get by a individual person. It can be get only by a group of people who are involved in that business for a long time. For example, Kanjipuram silk. The persons, a group of people or community belongs to that Kanjipuram who are manufacturing the Kanjipuram silk only can get this geographical indication protection. Individual people like us will cannot get geographic indication. Or a particular or individual people can get for trademark only. If they want to do sari business, for example, Pothis, na, they will get Pothis as a trademark. They cannot claim as Kanjipuram silk. The group of people who are living in the Kanjipuram, who are manufacturing the silk, only can get Kanjipuram silk tag. Because of that origin, that product having some special quality. Okay, wow. So geographical indication will be valid for 10 years only and can be renewed indefinitely. This patents is valid for 20 years. Geographic indication valid for only 10 years. Trademark under this can be renewed indefinitely. Because again, you can, you are going to do business. So you have to, every 10 years, you have to renew it. Okay. See. This is one of the best examples for geographic indication. Darjeeling tea. Suppose you are starting a business, tea business, having producing the tea bags or a tea shop. You cannot keep a name as Darjeeling tea because Darjeeling tea is only available in the Darjeeling. The mannin magimai solvanga. The quality of the sand. The quality of the place is very, very important because that product is originated from that place, it having some special quality. The same tea which is grown in Nilgiris or some other place will not get the taste of Darjeeling tea. Darjeeling tea will having its unique taste only because it is produced in the Darjeeling area. Okay, so because of that area, the product having some peculiar character, that is called as geographical indication. Geographical indication can only be get by a group of people who involved in tea manufacturing in that particular place. The Kanjipuram silk. You can sell Kanjipuram silk in anywhere. You can get Kanjipuram silk throughout India, but you cannot use the name as Kanjipuram silk as a trademark. Kanjipuram sarees means only from Kanjipuram. That too from the group of people. They got already the GI tag, GI protection. They can only use the tag. But in particular Kanjipuram silk, you will have, you can see the GI tag. GI tag. They will say as GI. GI means geographical indication protection. That means this product is coming from exactly from Kanjipuram. No duplicate. Salem fabric. Salem fabric is another example. Solapur, Chandar and Terry Towel. These are manufactured in that particular area. Mysore silk, like Kanjipuram silk. Mysore silk is also a unique one. Madurai Sungudi Sari is one of the GI. Mysore Agarbatti. Agarbatti manufactured in the Mysore. Chennapatna toys. The old type of toys. Got a GI tag. Thank you. So far we have discussed briefly something about intellectual property rights. I hope you have got some idea about it. It is not an extensive seminar for making everything clear. Isn't just a brief idea through this webinar. This can be done, I think. So you have some idea about intellectual property rights. What is intellectual property rights? What is the benefit of intellectual property rights? In that intellectual property rights, you have patents. It is especially for invention related to technology and design to attract the customer, trademark for doing business, and copyright for literary and artistic work and geographical indication. So these are all branches. Through these branches, we are doing having several type of protections. So if you have any doubt, you can ask.
Yes, thank you, our guest, Mr. Vidhik Chandan Shankar sir. A lot of information. Before that, we have too many questions in our mind. What is property? What is the part? What is rights? So these are basic questions in our mind. I think, I hope, every one of us, we have a clear idea about basic ideas about intellectual property rights, what the difference between the rights, patent, property, what do we try, in what way we have to register our own ideas, invention, innovation, designs, colors, all this is here. Sir, my question is, before I have the questions here, now this is an open forum to ask questions here from our participant side. Please raise your question, sir. Please.
Sir, good morning, sir. Thanks for your valuable presentation. This is Chokalingam. And it's such a nice presentation, sir. And I just wanted to know whether in India we are awarding patent in the base of product or in the base of design, sir.
Product and designs also getting, sir. But when it is a product,
okay,
it will be protected through patents.
Okay.
When it is design, we are going for only design. It will be protected under design protection.
Okay. And is there any difference between that? In US, they are claiming for designs. That's what.
In India, it is two different, sir.
Okay, sir.
Patents and designs are entirely different.
Okay. Whether that these things will cover under copyright, the software, other things will come under the copyright, sir. Copyright.
Yes, means, yes, sir. Yes.
Okay.
Copyrights, softwares are coming under the copyright.
Okay, sir. Another query, sir. Suppose I had registered for patent, and you were asked some technical queries with me for doing the process of inspection. Hmm. And I have failed to submit that within a specific period of time, whether that patent will be void, whether my application will stand void, or I can reapply for the patent, same patent again.
No, sir. Time period is very, very important in patents.
Okay.
Suppose you are not answering, or suppose you are not meeting the requirement within the time limit, it will be abandoned.
Okay, be abandoned. Okay. Can I apply the same? In this, can I apply the same design for the patent again? Is it possible?
No. Once it is abandoned, means it will be open to the public.
Okay.
Nobody can apply. Even you cannot apply.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And thanks for your eye-opening session, sir. It's really a nice session. Thank you, Madaran sir, for allowing me as a participant again. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Chappalingam sir. Thank you, sir. Yes. Any more questions?
So good afternoon to all. So this is Dr. Catherine. I'm from Ahmed University Business School, assistant professor. I am working here. So without our almighty blessing, this could not be possible today. So I give thanks to our chancellor, vice chancellor, our registrar, executive director, Dr. Deepa Rajesh ma'am, and our HOD, Dean, and other faculty members, those who are belong to our university and other university also, those who present here as a participants. We thank you all. And our resource person, Sir, Mr. Uday Shankar sir, very good, innovative, and very more simple examples you have given, so much of examples to clear the simple doubt till now. We also have taken our classes regarding all this IPR, like what is patent, what is trademark, copyright, but from your webinar speech, this seminar could have given more insights about the concept called IPR. IPR means we have four sub points in that. We have given so many examples for each from starting TVS motors and paper clip, small paper clip. In that also we can get a patent. We can design. We can have a different designs from that. Even from the syringes. So all these are very good examples, sir. So I think participants got a full idea, full knowledge from this seminar. So I'm very thankful that for this seminar I've given so much of knowledge regarding designs. Even designs get a good IPR right. You can get a IPR right from designs, from trademarks, from copyright. We all know copyright. But there is in India, this is a practice call. That is what you have explained in the last for our participant even asked question regarding in India, we have four different offices, especially for separate for patent, for separate for design, separate for trademark and copyright. So this is a very good seminar. Thank you for your valuable knowledge sharing, sir. Thank you, Vishwakar. And
thank you,
our convener, Anugrah Sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.